Clip automation allows you to record changes in device parameters directly to clips and can be used in production or live performance. Let's take a look at how this works. When you're working in live, using the mixer or devices, you might want to control the movement of parameters over time to become part of your musical composition. The recording of such changes is known as automation. Almost all parameters in live can be automated. Let's take a look at how you can record automation into a clip. In my current live set, I have three clips playing. I'd like to record some automation into the first track. I have a simpler device playing my chords, and I'd like to automate the filter. The first thing I'll do is arm the track. Then I will toggle the automation arm button. This means that when enabled, as soon as I hit the session record button, I can now start to record automation directly into the clip. I'll record some automation of parameters one at a time using the mouse cursor. However, you can record more than one automation simultaneously. For example, if you're using a MIDI controller, the automation is recorded over the duration of the clip. When I finish recording the automation, I'll toggle the session record button to off. If you record the automation for longer than the duration of the clip, then the automation will be overwritten. It is also possible to record automation into all playing session clips, regardless of whether the tracks are armed or not. But to do this, you'll first have to go into the preferences. Under the tab Record Warp Launch, I can toggle Record Session Automation in Armed Tracks to All Tracks, depending on what I prefer. Now if I follow the same procedure and toggle Automation Arm and Session Record, I can record automation into all playing clips. To view the automation that I've recorded, I'll simply go to the clip view in the detail view and select the envelope box icon. In the envelope chooser, I can select any parameters from MIDI control, the mixer, or devices that have been loaded into the track. All automation control parameters that have been recorded have a red dot next to them. If I scroll all the way to the bottom of the chooser, I can select Only Show Adjusted Envelopes. By selecting this, I can now see from the chooser only the envelopes where automation has been recorded. Let's look at another method for creating automation in a clip. Rather than recording the automation using a MIDI controller or mouse gestures from Live's interface, we can add breakpoints directly to the envelope of a clip. Envelopes of parameters that contain no automation have a single dotted red line. To create automation, all I need to do is create some breakpoints and move them. For example, I like to automate the panning of track 1 between the left and right speakers. I'll go to the chooser and select Mixer. Here I'll choose a parameter, Track Panning. I'll add some breakpoints by simply double-clicking on the dotted red line of the envelope. I can now move these breakpoints to create an envelope that will automate the track panning. All breakpoints that I create will snap to the grid of the current clip envelope. If I want to change the grid, I can simply right-click and choose a grid. If I wish to move a breakpoint so it doesn't snap to the grid, I can hold Command on a Mac or Control on Windows and move the breakpoint. If there's a gradient between two breakpoints and you'd like to have a curve instead of a straight line, if you move the mouse cursor close to the line, it will highlight in blue. If you hold the Alt button down on your keyboard and move the mouse cursor, you're able to create a curve between the two breakpoints. If you press B on your computer keyboard, this will enable the Draw tool. You can use the draw tool to draw an envelope for your clip automation, as opposed to setting breakpoints. The draw tool will allow you to draw an envelope relative to the grid you are currently using in the clip. To change the grid, simply right-click and choose the grid that you would like to use. You can choose different resolutions for the clip grid, or set the grid to off. If you want to momentarily switch off the grid while drawing in the automation, simply hold down Command on a Mac, or Control in Windows, and use the Draw tool to draw your envelope